Hey, you're with TheEZGZ. What I want to share with you today is some knowledge about your throttle cable, the geometry, and how to set it up properly. It seems pretty straightforward. You have a cable going to a pedal, and you push down the pedal, it moves your carburetors, and it works. But if you want it to work better, listen to some of this advice. Try to find a pedal or something that has adjustments. If you're building your own, create some of these features in it. The stock pedal is designed such from the factory in a Volkswagen Beetle that it only moves so far. They've taken all the thinking out of it. But in an open car like this or something you're building yourself, a Baja car, it's really important to get this stuff right. If you look here, this has a stop, an adjustable bolt that will stop. So when you push down and hit the stop, you should have full throttle at your carburetors. They give you three choices to mount this cable right here. It was in the middle position on this particular setup, and this afternoon I changed it. I moved it down. I recall doing this on other cars that I've had. This also has a feature. I hope you don't get dizzy looking at this, as it has this little shelf designed into here, and this, the sole of your shoe or boot or tennis shoe, our toes can rest up against that. It kind of keeps it in position. It's important to have your feet in a good position. It's also a nice feature and very helpful to have a heel rest right down here. Something to put your heel up. I just added this a little while ago. It's too thin. I wish it was at least an eighth of an inch or 3/16. It looks like it's real small, and I don't know how it's going to last, but I just jammed it down in there. It made a world of difference. It allows you someplace to jam your heel so that your foot can pivot over to the brakes without really lifting your whole foot off of the floor of the buggy, because when you lift your foot off the floor of your car, you're using your hip muscle, and it's a long ways away from down here where you're using your foot. It will make your leg tire, it's hard on your hip, and it's better if you have your heel planted on the floor where you don't have to use your hip muscles. You can use your calf muscles. Your calf muscles are very tough, very strong, and when you just have to pivot on them, you got much more control. The road race cars, you know, you've heard of the heel and toe, downshift, clutching, all those different things they have. They have a lot of pedals, they have everything close by, and they also have a place to rest your foot. This footwell does not have enough room to put a separate footrest, and I horribly missed that. I was thinking about actually bending this clutch arm so that it gave my foot a little bit of room, but when you're pushing the brakes, you don't want to be pushing in on the clutch with the same foot at the same time. Not in this application. In the past, I've used different types of cables and wires. I found that out of a 60-something Volkswagen bus, they used a loop on the end instead of that squirrely little wiggle thing, and I ran the bare wire. You can see right here where at some point in time somebody welded these tubes in here. They probably wore out this one and then added another one in front of it, and this was either for the clutch cable or the gas cable, it's hard to say, and now they've gone away to the hydraulic clutch, and which I don't like, and they've using this Morse cable, which I do like. But in the past, I had done something similar. I put an eye here. I had a Teflon thing inside there. I did all this fancy stuff so my throttle wouldn't stick, because your throttle cables will saw into that and then start pinching. If you use a solid tube, a lot of guys like to use brake line and stuff like that. They just fill full of crap. You can use pieces of it. You could actually take a hose clamp and put it around this round tubing and capture a piece of tubing, but you're going to be changing it out every few runs because it's going to start sticking. even if you try to seal the end, the seal itself will cause some sticking problems. That's why I like the solid wire. Another feature about doing it the way I described with the wire was you could put the palm of your hand on the edge of the seat, not use your foot at all, and reach down with your fingers, and the heel of your hand being on the seat, you could just pull up on the throttle and hold it at a constant throttle position, and the whole buggy would run a lot smoother. You come off the big sand dunes and back into the staging area, and it's all whooped out and choppy from people running back and forth. It's the most used spot of the sand, and that would have been a time when I usually use that, because I just wanted to go nice and steady, slow speed. I'm not slamming through there as fast as I can like the guys on the quads and side-by-sides who have better suspension. But that was a nice little side feature of having that. You do need to secure your cable. This has got a really cool securing mechanism. It's part of the Morse cable system. The cable lifts out. It has a groove in the housing there, and then it has a capture lever that captures it. Man, that is sweet, and it seems to be working pretty good so far. Now you get back here, and you're coming through your fan shroud with a cable. That's a place that you can cut into things and get binding and stuff. You want to make sure that's correct. And then the distance from the center of this rod to your connection point is going to contribute to how fast or how slow your throttle works. Whether you get that full control. Sometimes you'll have different setups that have different places to put your different holes. By having it on the short end about your gas pedal and farther away back here, that gives less movement. I want a lot of movement on the pedal for a little movement on the throttle here. And as we come back over here, it's the same thing here. From the center of the pivot point to the center of this, the distance, that's all geometry stuff. You look at your throttle cable right here. You're on the idle stop, and the lever is not 90 degrees, but it's only going to move 90 degrees to get that butterfly in the full open position. You want this lever to be the same on both sides. You want this angle to be the same. It's a toss-up. When you're at half throttle, you should have 90 degrees between this vertical rod and the horizontal throttle lever. You got that? That's what you want to shoot for. You probably aren't going to get it. And you want to copy that exactly on the other side. There are throttle stops here. It's on the idle stop now. And this is your full throttle stop, which makes contact right here. And now what we've done is we've added that throttle stop on the back side of the gas pedal and have that adjusted so that if you do hit a bump, you're not stressing out, shaking all your linkage over here and bending things, because that's not a good thing. Okay? I hope that helps somebody. I think you can see it by this crappy example. I'm making my this video I've made several times trying to explain this. If this is your pivot point and this is your gas pedal and you have your cable, you have three connection points. We'll try to make them equal this time. You have your cable that comes down here. If you have it connected here and you move your throttle this far, what happens if you have it, the higher up you have it, the greater the distance that this cable is going to move. So by lowering it, you're reducing that. You have to move the pedal further to get that same amount of travel. And that's what you want to do. When you hit bumps and your foot is this pedal is jiggling around, you don't want it to be moving, activating your throttle as much. You want to, what I call, is slow down the throttle action. If you're drag racing or if you're driving on the street, even driving on the street, it's annoying if you have too sensitive of pedal and it starts jerking around and stuff. That's why they give you three holes to set it up for different people's preference, and depends on how you have the rest of your throttle linkage set up. Okay? Hope that helps somebody. Okay, just for comparison's sakes, this is a popular crossbar linkage setup. We're going to look at a different brand here on the Tub Buggy. And on this one, it looks like just a junky homemade thing out of a piece of angle iron, right? Well, actually, it's pretty expensive. This is a Gene Berg style linkage from back in the 70s. He made this popular, and he still sells it today. It's hard to find, but it is available, and you will pay for it, but it works great. It has your full throttle stops right here. It comes back to the idle stops. Now, these don't have the left and right hand thread, and this looks kind of loose, doesn't it? But that just means it's not putting any tension on the setup. When you apply the pedal, both sides, the left and right sides, engage at the same time. This will stay in adjustment for a much, much long period of time compared to the sand car without that gas pedal stop setup. It's something that people with dual carbs always complain about, and it's very annoying to be ready to go someplace and your car suddenly doesn't seem like it's not running right. It's like, you know, it just is the way it is. It has the same stop adjustment here. It has the same kind of looseness here. What you do to fine tune it instead of the left and right is you actually put a crescent wrench on here and bend this left or right to fine tune it. It's got extra return springs right here in the middle, which is just fantastic. You rarely will have this thing stick. It works great on off-road. This is a stock fan shroud. It's made to attach to a stock fan shroud. It's not going to work on some aftermarket thing. It does attach. It uses the coil mount bolt and the two top fan housing bolts above the alternator and generator slot. And you might want to add another washer behind this side here. Actually, the coil bracket fits behind the angle iron to make the same distance here. This is an outstanding setup that a lot of people made fun of. A lot of competitors made fun of it back in the day. Now, as we look over here at the stock style pedal assembly, that works superb. It's not as pretty as that one in the sand car with the aluminum and the hydraulics, but this works superb. And it has the natural feature with the gas pedal to your foot rests against the tunnel. So it rubs a hole in your carpet eventually, right? And that's why, because your foot has a tendency to flop, your feet flop out to the sides, your legs spread apart, your toes flop out. And on long cruises, you know, you just want to be relaxed. You don't want to be holding your feet in a certain position, right? Boy, I wish I had an extra one of these around. I'd put it in the sand car. That's my turning brake. Okay, we're going to take a quick look again for comparison. Here's the Baja. This put 10,000 miles on it last year and haven't done any long trips. We run it every day here. Same type of setup. Gene Berg setup. Got your springs, your return springs there. Got your throttle stops. This is very old setup. This original one with the 42 Weber Specials, Gene Berg style, on Gene Berg manifolds. I have a feeling that I took it off of a 2-liter engine on a car that came from California. So this was originally came with a good setup. It has his oddball square air cleaners. I had special outerwears made for it, and it works great. So I hope all this information about throttle control and throttle position helps somebody. That Morse cable is a great aftermarket setup. That CNC pedal is a great pedal, or any similar one that has the stops so you're not bending your linkage. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subbing. Easy Jeezy